I'm going to go check on those boys. What?
Nothing.
No, I know that sigh. What?
When we entered this relationship, we both agreed that we were both people who did not want kids.
What do you expect me to do with them? I thought their father would show up in no time. Do you know he's never even told them he loves them?
You know what I think? I think you're trying to compensate for the loss of your own parents. You never talk about that.
You want me to talk about it? Fine, I'll tell you all about that fateful summer. The summer of the monarchs. I was a mere 8 years old. Practically a caterpillar by butterfly standards. My parents' private jet crashed in New Jersey's fabled Pine Barrens minutes after takeoff from Newark Airport. Miraculously, I survived. My parents were not so fortunate. When I came to, I was surrounded by the most enchanting monarch butterflies. In time, they took me in as one of their own. They became my foster parents. These were the halcyon days, at play with my butterfly brethren. I learned the mysterious secrets of their ancient ways, supping as their own young do on a steady diet of milkweed, thus assuring my toxicity to this day. Then, one fateful morning in September, I remember because it was right around my birthday. I was ecstatic by autumn's approach because it meant the leaves of the trees would be orange enough for me to build even more convincing monarch wings. I awoke and looked for my monarch family, but I couldn't find them. I searched for days, but no sign of them. It was like losing my parents all over again, only much quieter. So I wandered to the nearest highway, took the first bus to New York, and claimed a fat inheritance. It was only later that I learned that monarchs migrate south for the winter, here, to Mexico. Oh, Tenderoni, that's the only real reason I've come to Mexico. To find my foster parents. My big plan, all that work I've had you doing. It was just an excuse. Do you hate me now?
Oh, sweetie. Butterflies only live about 9 months.
What?
But those boys downstairs are alive. And you're right, they do need a father. So you go down there and you love those boys and never let go.